Come by the hills, we meet you there. Come by the hills, we meet you there.
Well, I think the basically the difference between the Viper times and the follower bands is the innocence. When we were teenagers and we were supposed just to, you know, play football as every Brazilian. I mean, we did play football, but at the same time we also put up a band. And of course, nobody knew how to play anything back then, but we were interested in music and we started to learn by ourselves. But the feeling of innocence, the feeling of, I mean, the whole passion for the music, it started there. Something I still, somehow I feel that I carry it inside. And it's a gift probably from those times. They have grown inside of us as a seed, you know, as a plant that you will always bring along. And after this, I think, you know, the bands became way more professional, even more serious. But I'm thankful that I still carry this seed that I started to cultivate back then when I was a teenager. Well, if I have the chance to give an advice to young musicians and to boys and girls who are starting to play an instrument, I would tell them, first you should try to learn piano. You might choose another instrument later, or not. But to have the to have the knowledge about music based on the piano playing, I think it's very, very useful. And I mean, for me, the piano playing is like it's something that was always there. At a certain point in my life, I really had to take a choice. I had to decide whether I would become a classical musician and an actual piano player, or if I would follow my path with a band. And that was actually my choice, the second one, because I thought that in this sense I could have much more freedom to express myself. The funny thing is that I didn't start up as a singer at all. I started in music with piano, playing the piano, the classical piano. And when I joined Viper, my first band, they wanted me there as a singer. But I remember I told them, I'm not a singer, I am a piano player. I didn't even say keyboard player, I think I said piano player. I'm not a singer, I don't know how to sing, I cannot do that. And they said, no, but we want you to be the singer. I said, but why? I just play the piano. No, because you probably are the one who sings the least worst of us all. And on top, we think you would look a little bit like Bruce Dickinson from Iron Maiden, so it might help. I said, okay, I can try. So in the end, didn't play keyboards in this band. I was basically singing. And it was cool, it was fine. It was a chance to develop something that later on I became also more fascinated about. But I think a big part of my singing comes from my piano playing. In a live situation, it's very important. If the vocalist is not 100% there and not 100% convincing, I think the band would be in trouble. But it shouldn't be something like faked. I think that you really must feel it. There is something special out there when you step on stage and you start to have this kind of communication. But you must be 100% there. You must be with your full soul in what you're doing, and you must deliver it. So it's very important, I think, in my opinion, to be concentrated before a concert. And this for me is really sacred, you know. It's like I need my moments before the concert so I can start to get into this mood, because it is a real transformation.